It is a sea of colour, music and entertainment in one area of the city, but this year the party has been put on hold. Organisers of the Kemptown Carnival have decided to bring a standstill to proceedings as they try to balance the books. The event, which last year attracted over 20,000 people, has accumulated debt of around £12,000 since 2011, something which directors say couldn't continue.
It costs a lot of money to put on the carnival each year, with a lot of volunteers helping out, but the expenses then never go down. So whereas we might have been able to get parking bay suspensions for nothing, we've had to pay for those parking bays, 40 odd quid per parking bay, and there's not a lot of parking bays along the footprint of the carnival. Those have to be paid for. Even the police, who have to come and have a presence on the street during the event, they have to be paid for. So nothing is for free these days.
With the sound of the steel drum silenced, some businesses on St George's Road aren't necessarily losing trade from a lack of carnival, because they say they're forced to close early. Harry Farmer, whose family run the Kemptown Deli, says the growth of the event has had a negative impact on local traders.
It was our busiest day, but because of outside revenue has made a difference, bringing outside other shops in, which kind of took away from us because there were so many other different options. So last year wasn't our best year, even though it was the busiest carnival that they'd had for years, so it did make a slight difference.
As St George's Road puts the festival aside for 1 year, organisers are set to hold a public meeting on whether the street party will continue in 2016. Despite the large turnout, unless those organising and attending have deep pockets, then an event with so much colour could come to an end. This is James Dunham for Latest TV News.